Good morning, students. A very warm welcome to your second year of MSc on behalf of Department of Botany, KTHM College, Nasik. Students, we are meeting after a very long period of time. And first of all, I will going to ask you, how are you? I hope you will all fine. And for your safety, we have started our online sessions. Students, we know each other from last year, but still, I will going to introduce myself very shortly. Students, I am Sucheta Bidwe and I have completed my MSc and MPhil from Savitribai Phule University, Pune, and I have qualified my SET examination also. Students, last year, we have dealt with the subject molecular biology, and in this year, we are going to deal with the plant physiology. Now, when we say the word plant physiology, what will appear in front of you? Yeah, I know. Photosynthesis and respiration, which are the most basic processes of all the living world. But still, there are many different processes we are coming in this plant physiology, and we are going to study all these processes coming under the plant physiology in this semester. Students, let's take a brief introduction of initially the subject. Students, our subject code is BOUT233. You have to remember this subject code because it will helpful you during filling your examination form. Students, name of our subject is plant physiology. Students, from last year, you are subjected to CBCS system. And within this system, there are some compulsory papers and some choice-based papers. And this plant physiology is your co-compulsory paper. So you don't have any alternative to this theory paper. This paper is consist with 4 credits and each credit is having weightage of 15 lectures. So the whole course is of 60 lectures. And in this semester, I will going to deal with the credit 1 and credit 4. Okay, means I'm going to cover your 30 lectures portion. Okay, so today we are going to see a very shortly outline of our syllabus. We're going to see what are the main concepts are coming in the credit 1 and credit 4. Okay, so let's have a very short introduction to our syllabus. Students, name of the first credit is plant nutrition. Okay, now again, we'll go to word nutrition. Now, when we say about the nutrition, what will come in front of us? Obviously, our food. And plants are the supplier of this food. But still, this supplier are also required some specific nutrients, and in this credit we are going to see what is plant nutrition. Okay, so in this credit our first topic is soil. Now, what is soil? Okay, in very shortly we can say this: soil is a skin of earth which we see, within which we are sowing our plants, and the plants are growing within this soil. So in this topic, we are going to see how this soil is formed, what is the structure of this soil, what are the components of this soil, means composition of soil and classification and important role of this soil in the growth of plant. Okay, now, just now I say that there are various components of the soil, and we have already shortly studied this component of the soil, I think in 11th or 12th. These are the essential elements and non-essential elements which are present into the soil. Okay, so our second topic is essential elements. This essential element mainly having or it consists with minerals and non-minerals. These minerals and non-minerals are classified as essential elements and a non-essential elements. Or first, the essential element consists with minerals and non-minerals. There are some criteria which are going to decide how the minerals are essential for the plant nutrition. Then we are going to see the role, catalytic osmosis, which are influencing the essential elements, as well as there are various factors like pH, microbial activity, which interferes the absorption and utilization of this essential element. In this second chapter, we are going to study what are these essential elements, what are the criteria of essentiality, their role in the development, in the metabolic processes of the plant. The next topic from the same credit, which is also very important, which is explaining how these mineral elements are absorbed by the plant. What are the mechanism of the absorption of these mineral elements and how they are circulated within the plant to the each and every part of the plant. So our third topic is mechanism of absorption of minerals and mechanism of assimilation of sulfur, phosphorus and nitrogen. We know this sulfur, phosphorus and nitrogen is very, very important for the growth of the plant. Why did so? If you remember this molecular biology, in structure of DNA, we have studied the nitrogen and phosphorus are the most important element of the DNA, which are important for the formation of, for the formation of nucleotides. Likewise, sulfur is also very essential elements, and as well as this nitrogen is important element required for the formation of proteins, and therefore mechanism of assimilation of nitrogen is very, very important. And in this chapter we are going to study this mechanism of assimilation of nitrogen, phosphorus and sulfur. Now after assimilation, there is question comes of transport. Okay, and therefore we are going to see various type of transport which are takes place into the plant for the absorption of minerals as well as for the distribution of these minerals within the plant. And the chapter is here for active and passive transport, transporters, role of ATPase and PPase in the active transport and passive transport. In the next chapter, we are going to study the merits and demerits of natural and chemical fertilizers, various conventional and modern methods of application of fertilizers. The next chapter is properties of water. If you remember, in SYBSC, we have already studied the properties of water, water potential and the factors influencing the transport of water. In next chapter, we are going to study mechanism of opening and closing of stomata. Okay, what is stomata? Have you remember? Okay, good. So mechanism of opening and closing stomata, transpiration ratio and water conservation strategies in the plants. Now in SYBSC also We have already studied the mechanism of opening and closing of stomata. If you remember, the part of the metabolic process related with this opening and closing of stomata is, yes, it is a osmosis. So we are going to cover all these seven chapters into the first credit, that is plant nutrition. So in the plant nutrition, overall we are going to see the soil, the main important part, components of the soil, how these components, means minerals, are absorbed in the plant, the mechanism of absorption, mechanism of their transport, their merits, demerits, and how water is going to important part for this activity. Okay, our next credit, that is credit 4th, is solute transport, growth and development of the plant. If you remember, we have already studied some part of growth and development in SYBSC. Okay, now when we are saying the growth and development, what is the difference between growth and development? Yes, growth is irreversible phenomenon. Okay, growth is irreversible change into the height and weight of the organism. Okay, and in case of plant, the growth is concerned with increase in length and width of the plant. Why? What is development? Development is a switching of plant from one stage to another stage. For example, when we sow a seed, it will going to germinate to form a small plantlet. Okay, means there is development of seed to plantlet. After completion of vegetative growth, plant is switch itself into the reproductive phase. So again, there is switching from vegetative to reproductive. It is again another part of the development. So in this credit, we are going to see this growth and development. The first chapter from this credit is seed dormancy, types of seed dormancy, causes of seed dormancy, and methods of breaking this seed dormancy. This chapter we have already studied in SYBSC. So we are going to see very shortly this chapter, and it has a weightage of only one lecture. In next topic, we are going to see the growth. What is the phenomenon of growth? Then relative growth rate and net assimilation rate and IRGA. Now in this topic, you have all these new terms like relative growth rate, net assimilation rate and IRGA. What are these factors? We will see at the time of that chapters directly. The next chapter is physiology of flowering. Now again, we have shortly introduced already with this chapter in our SYBSC. So you are familiar with this phenomenon very shortly, like physiology of flowering is, it is something which is related to the flowering and which is affected by the light. Okay, and mainly the phenomenon which is concerned with this light period and flowering is called as photoperiodism. And we are going to study this photoperiodism in this chapter, as well as we are going to study the mechanism of vernalization in this chapter. In next chapter, the first part is totally for your home assignment. In your syllabus, they have already mentioned you have to complete this topic by home assignment way. And that part is physiological organization of phloem elements for transport. Okay, you have to cover this topic by home assignment mode. The next part is loading and unloading of phloem and mechanism of transport of solutes, which is a Munch hypothesis. Then source and sink relationship. We are going to see this part into the fourth chapter. In next chapter, we are going to study plant growth regulator, their types, and physiological role of auxin and cytokine. Okay, we all are familiar with this term very shortly, but in this chapter, we are going to see the detailed physiological role of auxin and cytokine. The next chapter, which is totally new for you, is a stress physiology. Okay, the word is stress physiology. Stress, something stress related to the stress. Okay, in Marathi, we are calling as a taan. Okay, so it is a stress physiology. What are the factors which are creating a stress on a physiological process into the plant? We are going to see into the stress physiology. Within this stress physiology, we are going to cover definition. What is this actually stress physiology? Then types of stress physiology. There are various factors. It may be a biological factors or it may be a non-biological factors. Like when we are saying about non-biological factor, it concern with the temperature, rainfall, then the soil quality, etc. are coming under the abiotic stress or non-biological stress. On the contrary, the biotic stress mainly concern with the pathogenic organism which are related or which are causing diseases into the plant. So we are going to see initially types of stress, which are biotic stress and abiotic stress. Then we are going to see effect of stress on a plant, and we are going to study any one specific example for one biotic and one abiotic tolerance mechanism which is developed into the plant. And the final topic from this credit 4 is, again, the first part of the chapter is concerned with your home assignment. You have to complete this part by your home assignment mean. That one is schematic presentation of secondary metabolite synthesis pathway. We know in a plant there is presence of primary metabolites as well as secondary metabolites, and the way of synthesis of this secondary metabolites, you have to work out this by means of home assignment. Okay, the next part is classification, biosynthesis and significance of alkaloids into the plants. Okay, that will we cover in our classes. Likewise, these are the 7 chapters coming into the credit 4. Now you will have an idea, in credit 1 and credit 4 we are going to study the factors which are related to growth of the plant. Okay, again, these are also physiological processes. Okay, on the contrary, I think in a credit 2nd and 3rd, you are going to study the main physiological process like photosynthesis and respiration. So, comparatively, we can say that credit 1st and credit 4 will be easier for you. For this credit 4 and credit 1st, we'll going to see some references for your study material. Within that, there are some very good books like Biochemistry and Molecular Biology of Plants by Buchanan. This book is available in our library. Okay, as well as this book is available in on internet also. You can download it. There are various another books, list of books like Introduction to Biochemistry, then Principles of Biochemistry by Leninger, then also Salisbury and Ross book of plant physiology. Again, there is very good book on plant physiology by Thays and Jeager. So all these books are available in our library, as well as these books available in soft copies also. Okay, then if you are interested totally a Indian book, you can follow a Verma and Verma's book. Name of the book is Textbook of a Plant Physiology, Biochemistry and Biotechnology. It is also a very good book, and a copy of book is available in college as well as it is available in soft copy also. Thank you so much. It is a brief introduction of our syllabus for credit 1 and credit 4. If you have any query, you can find me, you can mail me on my mail ID sujeta.bidwe@gmail.com, and samely I will provide you all the study material via email. Thank you so much.